Ça veut que tu te fasses une
One of the most beloved bands on the label was the Ramones. So how did you first hear about the Ramones? Was this like just dropped on your desk? Would they drop by a demo to your office? Was there a hesitation?
No. I'd heard about them for a while, but I'd been spending a lot of time in London, which I still do. It's another great world city for music, for everything. And they finally had a date at CBGB's, and I had just come back from London, but I had the flu. I was so ill, I couldn't make it down there. I sent my wife in my place. She's a school teacher in the Bronx, but loves music, and she came back raving about him. So as sick as I was, the next day I rented a little rehearsal studio for an hour and had them come in, and they played for about 15 minutes, about maybe 20 minutes, 18 songs in about 20 minutes. That's, you know, and I wanted to sign them so bad. We spent the rest of the time discussing the deal, discussing how quickly they could get in the studio, and you know, I told them on the way out, you know, go see a lawyer. And that first album was done within 2 weeks after that meeting. You know, Johnny Ramone in particular, if he didn't get 7 or 8 tracks done the first night in the studio, he would be very, very disappointed. And we'd all suffer for it too, I can tell you.